people do prefer to drive in their cars mostly by themselves.
Hey, this is Warren Redlich. One of the things I've been wanting to talk about for a while now is pod cars. Pod cars are something I see as small robotaxis that are designed to carry just one passenger. A single-seat car makes sense, but it just hasn't happened yet. We know that most trips involve only one person in the car most of the time, that somewhere in the ballpark of 1.2 or 1.3 average passengers per trip.
I mean, the average number of occupants in a car, I think, is like 1.2. And maybe with autonomy, maybe it'll go to 1.4. Maybe. But I'm not sure if that even, it even goes there.
When you're driving down the road, usually you see a lot of cars with just one person in them. And the truth is that a lot of times when you see more than one person in the car, it might be an Uber or a taxi driver and then one passenger. So really, the vast majority of the time that a car is used, it's only transporting one person from one place to another. There's a long history of one-seat concept cars. Various manufacturers, whether it's Toyota, Volkswagen, Audi, they've come up with these concept cars. They're never fully thought out. Generally speaking, they haven't been designed as robo-taxis. They've been designed for drivers. And there's a lot of features that seem unnecessary, like why are there doors on both sides of the car if there's only one person in the car? None of these concept cars have ever made it to production. This time it's going to be different. Tesla is going to make it different. The whole notion of self-driving cars and robo-taxis is going to make it different. And I want everyone to understand how pod cars are going to make our future so much better. We're heading for a future of self-driving cars. We won't need to operate the steering wheel. We won't need to operate the pedals. The car is going to drive itself. If you want to learn more about the future of self-driving cars, I made a video about Dojo, Tesla's program for developing the self-driving software. Look up at the top of the screen and you should see a link right now if you want to see it now, or check in the description down below and you should see an option there. I'll put a link in the description so that you can click and watch it after the video or whenever you're comfortable watching it. So in a robo-taxi world, a world where all the cars are self-driving, you won't need a multi-purpose car in your garage. When a lot of people talk about this idea of self-driving cars or, well, it's not going to be able to do this for me, it's not going to be able to do that for me, I need to be able to carry a lot of groceries, I need to take three kids with me sometimes. There's a lot of uses that we have for our cars today that may become less relevant in a robo-taxi world. In a robo-taxi world, you call for whatever car you need when you need it. You don't need a car sitting in your garage. You just say, hey, I need a one-passenger robo-taxi. I need a one-passenger pod car to take me from here to there. Oh, you know what? There's four of us. Hey, we need a Tesla Model 3 or a Tesla Model Y. Hey, we've got a lot of stuff to carry. Hey, send us a Cybertruck. In a robo-taxi world, you choose what kind of vehicle you need, and that vehicle comes to your house and picks you up and takes you where you want to go, carries what you need it to carry. And keep in mind, in a robo-taxi world, driving is inherently safe. Self-driving cars will be much safer than we are as drivers. They're becoming, if you watch the Dojo video, you'll see they're being designed to be as good as the best human drivers, with the bonus that they don't get tired, they don't use drugs, etc. They don't get distracted, so they're going to be better than the best human drivers, and you're going to see the number of accidents go down tremendously. Now, an important detail about pod cars, about single-seat robo-taxis, they will be much, much more efficient than the current cars we have today. The pod car of the future has a lot of advantages over our current cars. They're smaller, much, much smaller. They take less space on the road, which means the roads have more carrying capacity. Our current cars are in the ballpark of 12 to 15 feet long. Some are longer, but in that ballpark. With a pod car, you may be able to get down to 6 feet long. Our current cars are maybe 5 or 6 feet wide. Some are wider than 6 feet wide, 6.5 feet wide. With a pod car, with a human shoulder width being about, you know, less than 24 inches anyway, you should be able to get that pod car down to 36 or even 30 inches, pretty much less than half the width of the current car. Cut the length in half and you cut the width in half, then you're able to fit four times as many pod cars on the road as you're able to fit regular cars. Add in that robo-taxis will be able to follow closely because they'll be communicating with each other. Now you're eliminating the following distance. Maybe you have room for eight times as many cars on the road as you had before. I do have a concern that in a pod car world, there will be a lot more people on the road, but because of this advantage of pod cars, it won't mean we'll run out of space on the roads. our roads will be used more efficiently, not less efficiently, and we won't need to build more roads. We may be able to retire some, and we'll certainly be able to retire parking lots. Because the pod cars are narrower, because they're lower, and because of the advantage of not having to worry about certain features that you would need for a driver, they'll be more aerodynamic as well. They're going to be much more efficient when it comes to wind resistance. Having it be narrower means it has to push less wind out of the way. Having it lower height means it has to push less wind out of the way. And having a smoother designed car means that the air flows over more efficiently. So just in terms of when the driving gets to the point where the wind resistance matters a lot, they're going to be much more efficient in that sense. At the same time, they're going to be much lighter weight, which means when the car is accelerating, that's when it's using battery, using up battery to move the car forward, it has to accelerate less mass, so it uses less electricity. So that's yet another advantage of the pod car robotaxi. The pod car robotaxi will be much, much cheaper to build. Again, you're using less material, there's less mass of steel, whatever it is you're putting in there, there's less of it. You're going to be able to use smaller wheels, you're going to be able to use smaller tires. There's so many other things that you won't have to put in a pod car robotaxi. They're going to cost much, much less to build. So where today, let's say it costs Tesla $30,000 to build a Tesla Model 3 or a Tesla Model Y, it's going to cost them less than $5,000, maybe much less than that, to make a Tesla pod car robotaxi. They're going to be cheaper to maintain as well. With less weight, they're putting less pressure on the parts. There'll be fewer parts, so there's less to replace. Windshield wipers become unnecessary. A lot of moving parts that are needed for the driver become unnecessary. You only have one door instead of two. There's only one door to wear out instead of two or four doors. There's less things to break down. There's no mufflers, obviously, in an electric vehicle. All the things that go wrong in an ICE car, an internal combustion engine car, a lot of those moving parts, a lot of those fluids are gone. So they're more efficient and cheaper to maintain in that way as well. The biggest thing here, and I talked about this in another video, is we're going for the lower cost per mile. Currently, TestLoop, a company called TestLoop in California, estimates that it costs them 18 to 25 cents a mile to operate a Tesla Model 3. I think with a pod car robotaxi, we're going to see that cost per mile get down below 5 cents a mile. They're going to be extremely efficient. They're efficient because they're going to last long. They're efficient because they're not going to use a lot of energy. They're efficient because they don't have to be maintained as much. They're efficient because the lower cost overall means that cost, you have a lower cost amortized over a longer period of time. So if you have a $5,000 car that lasts 1,000,000 miles, it's only 0.5 cents a mile for the depreciation on the car per mile. The energy costs less because you're pushing less weight. So many different ways it costs less per mile. Now, one of the big things about the pod car robotaxi is it's going to need a smaller battery. Smaller battery because, well, number one, you've made it a smaller vehicle. It has less weight to push around or less weight to pull around. And the future battery technology, which I made a video about battery technology. And again, you can click the link above or you can look in the description below for that video about Tesla super batteries that are coming soon. With much lighter weight batteries, again, there's less for it to push around. Because the battery has less kilowatt hours in it, it stores less energy. That means it's quicker to recharge because you don't have to put as much energy in. The same charging rate will fill that battery quicker. And the biggest thing about a smaller battery is it means you can make more of them. A Tesla Model 3 might have a 75 kilowatt hour battery pack. If you get a pod car robotaxi down to a 20 or 15 kilowatt hour, let's say 15. Let's say you get the pod car robotaxi down to a 15 kilowatt hour battery pack. That means instead of using 75 kilowatt hours to make one Tesla Model 3, you use 5 15 kilowatt hour battery packs to make 5 pod car robotaxis. Tesla will be able to produce a lot more vehicles when they shift to the pod car robotaxi model. So the future of pod cars is really, really exciting. There's a lot of possibilities of how they're going to work out. I'm going to talk to you about a few ideas that I think seem somewhat likely in the early stages, and then where I think we're heading down the road. So the simplest thing is Tesla is building Model 3s and Model Ys, and there's talk about them making a new car designed in China. So that pattern of how they manufacture cars, I could see that it makes sense that they would use that model to build the robotaxi based on the same rough ideas, that there will be a skate, that there'll be a body on top of it. Everything runs on top of the skate. Now, the skate is going to be much smaller because we're building a much smaller vehicle. So a simple idea is to take something like the Model 3 or Model Y and shrink that package down to make a pod car robotaxi. It's really not that much different from the current Model 3, Model Y, just a lot smaller. I don't think that's really the future of pod car robotaxis, but it's a start. Many Tesla fans know that Tesla is planning to build Cybertruck, which is a different model in terms of how they're making it. There's no stamping, there's no paint shop, so it's much simpler to make. There's lower capital expenditure to develop the line to build the Cybertruck. So another theory is that there will be a Tesla Cyberpod, that they will make one passenger vehicles off the same rough platform as Cybertruck, but much, much smaller. Here you're combining the advantage of a smaller size with an easier and less expensive manufacturing process to get that cost of that pod car robotaxi down, while of course still looking really cool. Another idea is that Tesla is just going to do something completely different. They'll probably still use the skate, but the rest of the vehicle could be completely different. And I think that's where it's heading down the road, that you don't just take what you did before and repeat it. You try to figure out what is it they were trying to do and make it something that's ideal for what you're trying to do, and at the same time, something that's easy to manufacture the way you want to manufacture it. A really good example of this is in the robotaxi world, where crashes are basically unheard of. You may no longer need a sturdy structure to protect the occupants from a crash because there won't be crashes. You could simply make a shell out of recycled plastic that is very, very lightweight, and if something happens to it, you just toss it, recycle that into something else, and put a new shell on. And you can always change colors whenever you feel like it, because the cost of the recycled plastic shell would be very, very inexpensive. Another example of this is that there's no need for driver visibility. The car is driving, so the driver doesn't need to see out a window. It may be that you put windows in these cars, but it may be you decide, you know, we don't need windows. Adding windows may make the cost of manufacturing much more expensive, and you may be able to save a lot of money by not bothering to put windows in. And if the person inside wants to see outside, you can put a flat panel in front of them and have it fed by the cameras. And at the same time, if they don't want it to be fed by the cameras, they can play video games on it, they can surf the internet, they can watch movies, all kinds of things that they can do. That's just an example of how the future of pod cars can be in an age where the cars drive themselves. Now, one of the things that motivated me in making this video was watching these concept cars. I've seen pictures and video of these concept cars before, and it always seems like they just don't quite get it. Some of the concept cars I've seen were underpowered and had very minimal range and were designed for very, very short trips, which may have a purpose, but with the current state of Tesla's battery technology, Tesla's pod car robotaxis will be able to go much further and perform much better than some of the concept cars I've seen. Several of the concept cars I saw had a three-wheel design. Really, they're more like motorcycles than they are like cars. And it looks kind of cool, but it adds complexity. Really, when you go from four wheels down to three wheels, you're not saving that much and you're adding so much complexity that I don't think it makes sense to bother going down to a three-wheeled vehicle. The other thing I noticed about concept cars is all the unnecessary features that are built in because they're not thinking about a robotaxi world, and really, they're not even thinking about you only have one passenger. So you have two doors on a vehicle that has only one passenger, only one seat. Why would you bother having two doors? It's much less expensive to design the vehicle with only one door. Every concept car I saw had a steering wheel and pedals and a windshield so that the driver could see and an instrument panel so the driver could manage the car. In a robotaxi world, none of that is necessary. And as Elon likes to say, the best part is no part.
The best part is no part. The best process is no process. It weighs nothing, costs nothing.
If you don't include all these parts in the cars, they're less expensive to build. There's less things that can break. There's less things to maintain. So in a robotaxi pod car world, these are going to be much, much simpler vehicles. You don't even need a windshield or windows. You don't need steering wheels or pedals. You don't need mirrors. If you go to the real extreme, city cars, cars that are driving around cities that aren't going very fast, on good days where there's no rain, maybe you're in a climate where there's very little rain, they might not need sides. You might be able to just have a front and a back that's wide enough to protect the driver or that's wide enough to protect the occupant from the elements to whatever extent they're there. I think you're probably going to have sides on them, but I could see it, much like a golf cart doesn't have sides, you might be able to get away without even having sides. And again, saving more weight, making it less expensive to build, making it less expensive to maintain. And one idea I really like is what I call the AeroPod. And the AeroPod is designed instead of, a lot of the things that I came up with were really more city car, which is a very popular thing with the concept cars, is some sort of city car where it's just one passenger vehicle that's going around the city. But what about if you're going on a longer trip and you're going to be going at higher speed and you want that higher efficiency at higher speed? So I came up with the AeroPod, which is basically a very aerodynamic vehicle. Will be able to go well over 100 miles an hour while maintaining very, very good aerodynamic efficiency. Remember, again, it's narrower and it's shorter and it has that very aerodynamic shape so that it's able to be much more efficient in terms of energy efficiency at higher speeds. At the same time, you might change the gearing or the transmission. In a city car, you wouldn't be worried about the vehicle going 120 miles an hour because that would not be a typical use of a city car. It might be able to go 120 miles an hour, but you would design it to have its optimum efficiency at lower speeds. With the AeroPod, you wouldn't be worried about that short-term acceleration. You would be worried about sustaining the right level of power to maintain your speed at a high speed. So it would be geared, if that's the right word, geared to operate at higher speeds. And I think this would enable the AeroPod to travel long distances very efficiently, perhaps in loop tunnels built by the Boring Company. For more on how pod cars would play out in a robotaxi world, I did make a video called Tesla Trillions, which again you can see up above, or there's a link in the description below, where I talk about how this world of first robotaxis and then eventually pod cars will produce so much revenue and so much profit for Tesla. Hey, thank you for watching. I hope you liked it. Let me know what you think in the comments.